Hello there YouTube, how's the crack? Hope you're keeping well. Right, in this video we're going to have a look at the Behringer Mic 2200 preamp, which is one of the most commonly used preamps in this caper of messing about with audio on ham radio. These things can be picked up anywhere from 30 euros to 70 euros. I paid 40 for mine, in very good condition, second hand. So let's have a look at the unit. We'll show you the front and the back, and then we'll fire it up and show you what it's all about. Okay, so we'll start on the back, and have our standard IEC type power connector, and your input and output. These are a two channel device, so you have two inputs and two outputs. We'll only be using one, and we'll be going in this way here, in through the XLR. Because if we don't go in this way, you don't have use of the preamp to its full ability. So I have an old dynamic mic here. It's just an old dynamic mic, and I have an XLR to XLR lead made up for that. I just have this little tripod grip stand. So in front of it is split into two halves. So that's channel one, and there you have channel two, and we have our little tube in the middle. So we'll turn it on. You can see the tube is illuminated by a couple of LEDs in the back to show that tube type glow from days of old, I guess. I think, you know, the tube is incorporated in the preamp stage in this, but as to how much coloration it gives the audio is debatable, you know. I think it's more an ornament than anything else. We're going to have a quick look through the controls here. You can see it's peaking up to about 0 dB at times there. This microphone is not great now, to be honest, but it's just an old one I have lying around for doing test stuff like this. So when you're going in through the XLR connection on the back, you need to have this mic line button pressed in, which gives you access to control for the preamp here. The preamp on this goes from plus 10 to plus 60 dB, so we're somewhere around 50 dB with this microphone, similar to the microphone gain on the Frontier radio. If we back it off, the audio goes down. So dynamic microphones like this require quite a lot of gain, and it's normal to have it up this high. If I crank it all the way up, you'll see that the it's clipping now. You can see the clip light coming on there, and that's what you don't want. And you can see on the VU meter there, the output level meter, it's peaking to plus 12, plus 18 at times. If I really kind of raise my voice, it'll peak right up to the top. So you don't want it to go that high. This phase reverse switch here, this lad, the red guy. Now this is something that you don't use, but I'm just going to explain what it does. The phase reverse, it inverts the input signal by 180 degrees. This function is available in both modes, line and mic mode. And the idea of it is, if you were using a lead where pin 2 and 3 were back to front, and to save you soldering it, or it was just done wrong or something like that, you can hit that button and the microphone will work. Or if you're having trouble with reflections off the walls of a room or something like that, you can play around with it. I've tried it, it didn't really do anything for me, so I just kind of leave it off. Onto this frequency control here. This frequency control, it's used to select the frequency to be modified. You can raise or lower with these two buttons here, right? So the bottom button here will work on up to 200 hertz, and then this one will go from 1 to 20 kilohertz. Now you can't have the two of them pressed in at the same time. You either have one or the other, and I always used to have the bottom one. If you have both of them out like so, the frequency control, you can sweep it over a range from 100 hertz to 2 kilohertz using this lad here. That's what that's for. And if you have this one pressed in, you use this control here to modify the bottom end. Now onto the bandwidth control then. This determines the slope or quality of the filter, and it goes from 0.03 to 2 octaves. So you can kind of play around with that depending on your voice, anywhere between 1.2 and 1.8. So you can just kind of mess about with that and see which gives you the best result. Now, next up then is this level control here, and what that does is it determines the amount of level reduction or gain applied to the filter. So again, you can just kind of mess about with this, and to be honest with you, all this section here, you're not really going to use it because you're going to be EQing further on. So you know, it's not really going to be of any advantage doing it here when you're going to be doing it further on. So you know, you can, if you just have this unit on its own and you want to play around with it, by all means you can do that. So the EQ in out, this activates this for this section here, these two here, and then you have your output here, which you want at zero. The aim of the game is have unity gain. You want everything at zero most of the way through the rack, with the exception of the likes of the DSP1124P, the feedback destroyer. It, you know, minus 10 is kind of what you want to see going into that because it's digital, and that's kind of what's recommended if you read the literature on that. So that's pretty much it. You won't be using the other side of the preamp. You'll only be using the one side. Basically, you know, you just want to use it to amplify your microphone signal and send it through the rack. Like most of this other stuff here, you're not really going to do much with it, to be honest. The way I used to have it was, the only light was this one, and that's kind of pretty much where I had these controls set. Now, with a condenser microphone, your gain would probably be about there, because as I explained before, a condenser microphone is powered, so it's amplified before it gets this far. So it doesn't require the same level of gain as a dynamic mic needs. So there you are, that's pretty much it, and we'll come back in another video, and we'll probably have a look at the MDX 2600 compressor, and we'll run through that and kind of explain what it's used for. So hope you enjoyed the video. Give us a thumbs up if you liked it. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. Either way, I don't mind. And if you want to leave a comment, please feel free. And if you're new here, be sure to subscribe, and we'll get you again in the next video. This is George EI7 Kilo Oscar 73, and bye bye.